What is up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back for another quick little channel CG video. Today, I'm going to turn on the lights because it's dark in here. Today, I decided I'm just gonna vlog because I've been working on the Eldorado. I wanted an Eldorado video to be out like a day or two ago. I wanted the car to be running. I've been trying to meet goals to get it, you know, to the point where we can at least start it and run it a little more and we can make a full video on that. I don't wanna make stupid little filler videos about it. And there's been some exciting stuff happening with that, but it's just been taking a really long time figuring everything out, finding parts for it. As you guys know, parts for cars like that are not easy to find. Just been kind of waiting and it really sucks. So in the meantime, this is probably gonna be like a 2-day kind of vlog because today I wanna get the car a little bit detailed up. And then tomorrow, if we don't get rained out, we're going to be going to the third Super Cruise of the year. If you guys don't know what that is, I'll put a link up in the corner. I made a little like a cinematic video at the last Super Cruise. I filmed some of the pullouts and it was a really, really fun video. But basically near me, we have every week on Thursday night, a cruise night, which is really fun. It's just kind of a small group of the good old boys that get together and hang out with their old cars, and it's a really nice thing. 3 times a year, actually I think they're gonna be doing a fourth one this year even, but like 3 or 4 times a year they do what's called a Super Cruise, where they invite a ton of people out. It's like the biggest show around here. They usually have like, if it's a good one, if it's a good day, a lot of people come out, it's like 700 cars. And that's what's gonna be happening this Thursday over there at the Charcoal Corral. But anyways, that being said, I wanna get the PTGT a little bit cleaned up and ready to go. I already vacuumed out the trunk area. It was really bad back here because I've had like a weed whacker back here. I've been doing some landscaping jobs and I've been just driving the car around, so it got pretty dirty, but I just finished vacuuming it out. I used a little bit of interior detailing spray and it looks a lot better. And also, funny story about my subwoofer, I actually blew it up the other day. My friend Brandon, we made a video together a while back. We actually installed new mids and new tweeters in his van and kind of revamped his sound system a little bit because the stock speakers were blown out and just they sounded like crap. And he drives like 7-8 hours on a regular basis for work, so he really needed some better tunes going on in that thing, even though it is just kind of an old work van. We ended up hanging out and we installed a little 10-inch subwoofer because that's really what the system was lacking. The new mids didn't carry as much bass as the stocks because they're meant to support with a subwoofer. So the story goes that when we were actually doing that job and we got everything wired up, he was showing me about adjusting like low pass and high pass, or basically like the lowest frequency that the mid speakers will play and then the highest frequency the subwoofer will play, and finding a nice balance between the two and seeing what sounds best with the system. I had no idea that was a thing, and of course my head unit is aftermarket and it has that feature. So I was able to adjust the high pass so that my mid-range speakers that came stock on the car weren't distorting and it sounded 10 times better, and I was able to really crank my volume up more. But because of that, I forgot to like level out the subwoofer level because it was already maxed out. So basically I blew up the subwoofer. I thought I just blew a fuse. I put some fuses in it and I kept blowing them. The subwoofer sounded like crap. So it turns out that I actually blew the little dual sub. It had a good life and it cranked some good bass for how cheap it was, but it finally blew. This one I bought for like $5 at like a Goodwill store. It's a 4 ohm, so there's a lot of resistance and it sounds like crap, but at least there's a little bit of bump still before I can get a new system in the car. Anyways, now that I talked about that, and probably none of you guys actually care about sound systems, it's time to get back to detailing this car. It is pretty dirty, especially my door jams, as you can see. They're just a freaking mess. I'm just gonna shop back out the whole car and clean up the best I can. Then we'll get the car washed up and I wanna do a little bit of stuff under the hood. And then of course we'll resume tomorrow when we go to cruise night. If we go to cruise night, I guess we'll see. You'll know by the end of this video, but I guess for now I'm gonna shut my mouth and let's get back to detailing. Here in the light, I can do a little quality control inspection. It's looking pretty good. But next up is the door jams. I've got this old but fluffy microfiber towel and some West Coast Customs exterior detailer. That's what I'm gonna use to clean up the door jams really quick, and I'll give them a final wipe when we actually wash the car later too. Well, my microfiber took a beating, but that looks a ton better. I really need to use some flits on my door jams to get them shined up even better because they are scratched up really nasty. But we'll leave that for another time. So I'm just gonna go ahead and whip through the rest of these door jams really quick, and then I'm gonna take a break because it is hot as heck out here. And then I'll pick the camera back up tonight and we get this thing washed up, and then tomorrow we will hit the show.
6.5 hours later.
I think it's down to like 81 degrees. It's pretty nice. But I got the car in here up on ramps really quick because I wanted to check something. You guys might have heard it when I cold started it just a minute ago, but when the car is cold and I start it, it's just enough that one of the belts squeaks. When the car's warm, it doesn't do it, but I think it's that initial jolt when the car is cold that just enough that it causes it to slip a little and squeak and sound really annoying.
And sure enough, when I climb under here and give the belts a little tug, the alternator belt up here feels a little bit looser than the other belt. Just enough probably that it causes it to squeak. Belt seems perfectly fine though. That's a new belt I put on when I did the alternator. I'm just gonna tighten this down a little bit and hope that takes care of our problem. Kind of a pain on this car. There's no belt tensioner for the alternator belt. So basically you have to loosen the bolts. That one there and then the one up under the hood. And then there's a bolt way down in there up under the hood that actually adjusts the tension on the alternator. It's like a 13 millimeter and it's really hard to reach without a good wrench.
But I'm gonna do that really quick so that it stops squeaking and annoying the crap out of me. And then we'll get to finally getting this car washed up and looking great for hopefully a show tomorrow. And you've got to turn this bolt down in here a lot. I remember just sitting here turning and turning and turning when I put the new belt on, just trying to get everything put back together. I think that ought to do it.
Oh yeah, that feels almost even, a lot better. I think we'll call that good.
Now just gonna get these bolts tightened back down and give it a good yeet. Okay. All right, I think that's tight enough.
And I got that bolt down in there tightened up too, and everything is looking good. The belt feels good. It's just a little bit more snug than the other belt, which I think is probably perfect.
So I guess let's start her up and see if we hear any noise. We shouldn't hear any, especially because it's warmed up. Well, it didn't squeak, so that's a good sign.
I forgot to hit record on the camera just a minute ago, and by the way, pardon the wind noise, but something else I'm gonna do really quick here is fix this wire for the O2 sensor. As you can see, I tapped into it a while ago to see if I could get a little AFR gauge to work, but of course it reads differently than this does, and it's just weird, so it's not gonna work. I'm just gonna wait, I think, till I have a wide band before I try to even wire that thing up. So you can see, had it all soldered together and I just trimmed it apart. I really ghettoed it together just to see if it would work, and it was a really bad idea, but everything's holding together here really nicely, so I'm gonna wrap it and tape it up real good and just say it's okay. It's just a signal wire. It's not like the heater wire or power or anything, so I'm not too worried about it. Also, this other wire that runs way down in here was for the oil pressure. I tried to wire up the sending unit before and it just wasn't gonna work with that oil filter sandwich plate. So the wire still runs down there. It's just capped off and taped off down there. But I'm probably just gonna get rid of that as well. And the reason being is because this loom actually melted. It must be it gets so hot because it's right above the turbo that it just literally melted. This was some Walmart loom too, so it's not like it's really nice stuff. But I can't believe it must get really hot back in here for it to have done that.
So I'm just gonna skip past and get everything cleaned out of here and taken care of, and then we'll finally start washing this car.
Tomorrow.
All right guys, so it is now the next day. I got everything finished up last night. It was getting kind of late, but I ended up working on the mini bike a little bit, and I'd like to make a mini bike video very soon. So I really enjoy making them every once in a while, and I think you guys will enjoy this next video because we actually like tore the old engine all apart and everything, found what was wrong with it because it actually finally seized up. And I've got the new motor on it, and that's what I was messing with last night, and I got it kind of running. I need to do a few more little things, and then this weekend I think me and Dean are going to be going out and riding, so I'll film then and stuff as well. Let me show you guys really quick what I did and everything cleaned up now. So basically you can see there's no more wire here. And I didn't realize it before, but this is like a heat shield or something around the other wires. And it must be because it gets so hot because of the manifold and the turbo back there. And I didn't think of that before, and that's why my cheap Walmart wire loom melted. But I got all the wires taken out and I ran them back into the cab. And I capped them off back in there and labeled them and taped them off and everything. Also got the O2 sensor wire taken care of down here. But it's looking a little better. We got things cleaned up. I painted this really quick because that looked kind of like crap. A little rusty and stuff. You know, just a lot of little stuff like that to get ready for tonight because I want to, you know, pop the hood and keep that open for the show. We got it good enough, so I guess let's not waste any more time and get this car finally cleaned up a little bit.
Alright guys, the car is dried up and looking nice. I used a little bit of spray wax as well. The only thing left is to touch up the tire shine and it will be looking completely 100%. I really need to at least paint this bumper. Today when I was power washing it, a little bit more of my clear coat actually flaked off. It's in super bad shape and I almost sent it last night and went and got some spray paint and just sanded it all down for the show tonight. Actually, I posted a poll on my Instagram story and I was like, should I send it, guys? And quite a few of you actually said that I should go for it, but I'm glad I didn't do it now because I just found out that the Super Cruise got canceled for tonight. So unfortunately, we're not gonna be able to end the vlog with an awesome car show like I was hoping. They canceled it because of the weather report and it looked like it could be bad. And actually, now that I'm looking, looks like we could get some thunderstorms. But this September, they're going to be having one on a Saturday, which is something new because ever since the beginning, they've always had them on Thursday nights, but they want to try something a little different this year, try it on a weekend so more people can maybe come out. I think it's going to be awesome and I'm definitely going to be there hanging out and I'm going to be filming and everything. And if any of you guys are up in the area, you're like in upstate New York, Western New York State, mark that on the calendar. I'll put the date here on the screen because I'm not exactly sure what it is, but I know it's a Saturday and it's going to be awesome. So be sure and come out. If you're going to be coming out, hit me up in the DMs. I'll probably be posting on Instagram when I'm there and stuff. I got my Instagram story, so be sure and watch for all that. But unfortunately, it looks like that's not going to happen tonight. At least the car looks good though. So let me know what you guys think about the paint on the bumper. I want to at least get that done because that's the worst. Maybe I'll just sand it and I'll actually wrap it kind of like I did here. Or maybe I'll take the wrap off because it has a little bit of flaws in it. Do some better body work and just paint all of it. Whatever I do, I promise I'm not going to use Rust-Oleum. That was kind of like a last ditch effort. And I know it was a terrible idea and it probably would end up looking just as bad very shortly. But I think I'm going to get some base coat and I'm going to use this kind of as a practice project. So let me know what you have to think about that as well. Hit the thumbs up button if you would like to see that and if you enjoy the vlogs. But for now, since we didn't get to go to the car show, I think we should go out for a little spin in the PTGT and get some turbo noises and get some good car action because I feel bad that the video is going to end like this. I guess I should have expected this because the weather always sucks here. So, oh yeah, by the way, listen, no more squeaks. Ah, yes. It's only that engine light, which I need to reset that O2 code, but that's no big deal. So I guess let's go out for a quick little spin. I haven't got driving action in a video in a long time, so let's do that, get some turbo noises, have some fun, and then we'll finish up this little vlog. This has actually been a fun video, even though we didn't get to end it. On the best note, I always love making these style videos, and they're a lot easier to make than the normal content. And you guys seem to enjoy them too, but you know, your feedback is always appreciated. Well, it rained. As soon as I got home, a thunderstorm came and it started pouring. So I guess the show would have got rained out and it's good they canceled it. But that really sucks though. It would have been a lot of fun. Hope you guys enjoyed this video anyways though. I think it was kind of a fun little vlog. I enjoy filming this style of video every once in a while. So I hope you guys enjoy it as well. And I have good news. Parts came in for the Eldorado while I was gone. So tomorrow I'm going to be working on this thing and in a few days there will be a video up. And there's high potential I could actually get this thing running tomorrow. That's pretty awesome. I'm really hoping everything works out and we get this thing running and it's gonna be awesome. So be sure and stay tuned for that video. If you haven't already, be sure and go smash that subscribe button. Be sure and hit the thumbs up button if you enjoy this style video. And I guess that's about it. I'm gonna go inside and edit this video and hope that it doesn't rain all day tomorrow. Thanks again for watching, guys. You rock. God bless, and I will see you in the next one.